Alan Hunter with you, and I'm way gone. Whoa, are you way gone? Stayed out way too late last night, and I'm definitely not feeling fresh. Well, these are just some slang words, and this is a slang segment. Awesome, is that a word maybe you'd never be caught dead using? Or is it the word you use to describe everything from your favorite person to the best movie? Well, we asked people around the country what's in and what's out when it comes to their favorite slang words, and here's what they said.
Yo, dude, man, what's up?
Dude, a dud.
Totally cool, dude.
Whoa, get like 5 feet of air and get ride.
Gnarly bitchin', dude, like
getting vertical in a tubular pipe.
Like, oh my god!
No, this isn't a foreign language, it's just street jargon. This particular slang was once unique to California's San Fernando Valley, but is now used all over the U.S. Moon Zappa was the first to publicize the L.A. trend when she released Valley Girl in 1982. Groovy isn't anymore, but rad or radical is. Why? That's easy, because groovy is listed in the dictionary, but the slang definition of radical is not. So what do these words mean?
The great-looking guy is rad.
Rad.
He's rad.
Totally cute.
Yeah.
Hot.
Awesome.
We use, scroned. That means you messed up. Like, you scroned.
They're souked. That's like when you party.
But L.A. isn't the only place to hear street slang. New York is another.
L.A.'s more laid back.
You like, yo, what's up, dude? Let's party.
Yo, I'm totally amped. After the Handmaid's Tale and the color purple, I'm ready to read Matilda. It's going to be totally tubular, guys. So, back to the color purple. The color purple was written and published in 1982 by Harcourt. Taking place mostly in rural Georgia, the story focuses the life of African-American women in the southern United States in the 1930s. I'm sorry, guys, I'm sorry. Addressing the numerous issues, including their exceedingly low position in American social culture. So, back to The Color Purple. The Color Purple was written and published in 1982 by Harcourt. Taking place mostly in rural Georgia, the story focuses on the life of African-American women in the southern United States in the 1930s. I'm sorry, guys, I'm sorry. Addressing the numerous issues, including their exceedingly low position in American social culture. Okay, so the book that we are now reading is Matilda, and it is basically a children's book, and it's about a very smart girl who is ignored by her parents, and as she...
There was little change to the TV itself, but there was a growing number of TV accessories, such as the VCR and home game consoles like the Nintendo. Television also saw a significant boost because of more cable channels such as MTV or sitcoms such as The Cosby Show, The Golden Girls, The Simpsons, and Full House. Sitcoms also brought laughter as well as informing their audiences on life lessons. Television was also very cinematic in the way that they had vibrant colors. Home video recording also became increasingly popular throughout the United States households.
Jesse, it's for you.
How do you know she's not here to see me?
Jesse!
Adriana, have mercy.
How are you?
If she's here to see you, she's very nice to your friends.
There you are. Now how do you feel, honey?
I still feel yucky.
Let me check your forehead.
Movies were pretty big in the
80s.
Movies in the 80s usually came from New Hollywood. The 80s was the time when high-concept films gained popularity, where the films were easily to be marketable and had plots that could be easily summarized in a couple of sentences. The 80s also took a huge risk and increased the amount of nudity, which increased movie franchises in science fiction, horror, and action genres. With this, creating the PG-13 rating, which was also introduced in 1984 to accommodate movies that ranged between PG and rated R. Because of the controversial movies that had many action scenes. Movie genres such as science fiction, fantasy action, adventure, horror, and comedy were popular at the time. Movies that were big hits were Back to the Future, The Breakfast Club, Ghostbusters, E.T., The Goonies, Indiana Jones, Star Wars, Gremlins, Terminator,
and with the help of MTV, artist's career took off. The four main genres were pop, hip-hop, new wave, and hair metal.
The artists of each genre had an impacting factor on art, music, and fashion. The cable network MTV was the most important event to influence music in the 80s. This network allowed for artists to show off their music videos on national television, making them more known to the public eye. Artists and bands that changed music and made a statement were Michael Jackson, Madonna, Prince, Janet Jackson, Whitney Houston, The Beastie Boys, Ice-T, The B-52s, Guns N' Roses, Metallica, and Ozzy Osbourne.
In the 1980s, shoulder pads became the defining fashion statement, also known as power dress. Bright colored windbreakers were also a casual fashion item that was popular. This was also a time when double denim and slip-on checkered Vans were often worn.
The Sony Walkman is a tiny stereo cassette player with truly incredible sound. Put on a Walkman and see the world in a whole new light. Sony Walkman. The Walkman from Sony, the one and only.
Getting vertical in a tubular pipe.
No, this isn't a foreign language. It's just street jargon. This particular slang was once unique to California.
Wait for you, the spirit comes shining through, promising you a great day.
Has been making great days for more people for more years with more cereals than anyone. Corn Flakes, Rice Krispies, Frosted Flakes, Product 19. Trust your mornings to Kellogg's.
Key roles in today's society. Talking about people that have played key roles in today's society. The man that launched CNN in 1980. CNN was first 24 hours all news cable network, and on January 1st, 1982, CNN headline news began broadcasting.
Another person was Sally Ride. Sally was the first American woman in space. This just happened on June 18th of 1983 this year. NASA was looking for women astronauts in 1977. And she saw it in a school newspaper ad inviting women to apply for the astronaut program. She then decided to apply for the job, and she was one of the six women picked. Next up on our show, we will have our guest speaker, Ronald Reagan. And my friend Tom here will give us some background info on him.
Yes, Ronald Reagan has now became the 40th president of the United States of America. And he will be serving his term from 1981 to 1985. Possibly getting reelected to 1989.
And today I will be talking about Reaganomics. Reaganomics are a recipe I created to fix the nation's economic mess. It's a 30% tax cut, and it's mostly for the wealthy, so they can spend more and invest more into businesses and whatnot. Reaganomics are more formal.